Hello, today I'm going to review and test this Marantz Model 215 for you. And what I can say from this Marantz, that it is a very popular model. You also had the 2010.
Yeah.
That one is even, well, not more popular, but it because it, that 2010 is so rare, it is even more expensive than this 2015.
Yeah, but it is also a 2015 with 5 knobs.
Really?
Yeah, instead of 4. Yeah, that's one. That one is out there. Also very rare.
Okay, this I didn't know. This first time I heard. I had that 2010.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I thought it was, well, the funny story was one of my first videos 9 years ago. I was new in this hobby. I just discovered vintage stereo, and I had a dirty one, and I thought it was broken, because I had no clue of that the thing needs dioxide. I had no clue at all that it was just dirty, it was not broken at all, and I sold it very quickly to another guy thinking I'm selling a broken thing, and okay. Anyway, this the 2010 is 10 watt channel, so that one is the one what is more expensive because it is so rare that and if you are a collector, you want to have the whole series. Yeah, collectors want the complete series, and that 2010 is very hard to find. So this 2015 is not that rare. And you know what's the price of these Marantzes nowadays?
200
€200?
Yeah, I see.
Really?
Yeah. I have seen 2 times a 2010. Both were in Germany. And they were asking €300 for the full one.
Unbelievable. So, the value, once again, people do not pay. Sometimes, the value depends on how rare an item is. Because the collectors want to complete their series. So that's why that 2010 probably costs more than the 2015. You know, because this 2015 is better than the 2010. It has 5 more watts, so it is better. But because the 2010 is rare, it is €100 more expensive as this 2015. But this 2015, as you can see, it is completely symmetric built. Completely. No, let me start in the middle. In the middle, we have the balance knob. 4 knobs exactly in the middle. 2 knobs on this side. 2 knobs on that side. 2 switches over here. Yeah, and you have that same switch on and off size. And of course, they have the headphone connection. And because this is the size of the headphone connection, yes, they made the switches all in the same size. Beautiful, beautiful overthought design. Every Marantz had this design, this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful designs, and that's why they are that's why they are not only the sound, but because the looks is so beautiful, that's why they are so popular. And this is a baby Marantz, and 2015 watt, 1973. And as you can see, the tuner scale and this FM meter, they are completely dark blue, beautiful blue, and they are not. It's not powered by those original 8-volt 30 milliampere fuse bulbs. No. Those bulbs are long gone. They are. I don't think there's a factory what make those bulbs anymore. So what did people used? Because those bulbs were out, they used, what did they use?
The 8-volt 40 milliampere.
8-volt 40 milliampere. But 8-volt 30 milliampere is 2.4 watt. 8-volt 40 milliampere is 3.2 watt. That bulb gives more heating or warmth, and that's the reason because people start using those 8 volt 40 milliampere bulbs, that's the reason that many of those bulb holders, those plastic bulb holders, start melting. Because they were not made for the warmth of a 3 point or for those 3.2 watt bulbs. But even though the plastic was melting down, there were a lot of, in the beginning time of LED, there were many collectors who said, I only use original, I will not use LED because the light of the LEDs is too strong, not original, and blah blah blah. They had their reasons, but LED do not melt plastic because LED doesn't heat up as a normal bulb. So in the end, you know, 10-15 years later, everybody use LED bulbs in their monolithes because they see that a LED bulb is, well, long life first. The color is beautiful, more light. It is just more beautiful as the original.
Yeah.
So, and it's the same like when that Euro came to the Netherlands. You know, you had a lot of people, nobody complains anymore about the Euro. Nobody wants to go back to that gilder time. Everybody's happy with the Euro. And it's, you know, it's something new. People always, you know, who are used to the old-fashioned way, they don't want to change. You always have, those are the liberals. They do not want to change the old way. But yeah, you know, when times goes by, you know, that old-fashioned way or that old fuse bulb, you know, or that old transistor will find its competition in a newer model, and probably that newer model is always better, you know, most of the time. But it needs some time for people to get used to that new product. Now everybody is using LED bulbs, and you can see also the paper of this Marantz is changed because a almost 50 years old Marantz, if you do not use or change the paper, it would be greenish color, not blue but green. Yeah, and beautiful. Soon I will make a video. I have a Marantz 2235. I will show you how to change that paper, but that's for another time, another video. That thing needs new bulbs, some cleaning, and some new paper because the color is completely green. And then you know exactly what I mean. So if you are a starter. If you don't know what to buy, if you are a collector, then you need a piece like this in your collection, then you know exactly what I mean. But if you are a starter, you want your first Marantz, and you think, okay, I like this model, it's small, it's not that expensive, so I can find one for 150, 200 euro, what will be difficult for 150, but it is possible, you know. And it is your first Marantz, or you need one for the bedroom because it's only 2x15 watt. I don't think, well, you know, 15 watt in most living rooms, if you have good speakers for that, so well, it is possible. You can spin with this amplifier easy in a living room, easy, you know. And so you don't need real 2x100, you don't need it, you can spin with this thing. And the power usage of this, such a small amplifier like this, is only 20 watt, about 20 watt, and it's also very cheap, you know. If compared with a tube amp, of course that modern tube amp will give you more pleasure in sound. But it also uses about 160 watt, and this thing only uses 20 watt. It is a beauty. And also, if you need a complete revision, this small Marantz is much cheaper in revision than the bigger one, because it is faster. You don't need that many parts. and even the filter caps are small.
Yeah.
So you don't, you know, it is not, you don't have to pay 500 euro for a revision. I think 200 euro, 100, yeah?
No, I think less.
150?
175, 150.
175, 150, you have a complete revision from this small 2015. And then, well, so it have its advantages if you don't have a big pocket, you just want something nice, something vintage in your house, I can understand. An eye catcher, even if the thing is small, it is still an eye catcher because of the beauty. And there's nothing new in the shop like this, my friends. Even if this is one of the smallest, it is only 35.8 centimeters wide. Even though it is this small, there's nothing in the shop nowadays what can compare with the looks of Marantz. And the sound? No, the sound is good, my friends. Listen to this. Let me first try the tuner.
No, the tuner is not connected.
Tuner is not connected, okay. No. Let me show you how much I like this thing because the sound is just beautiful.
Yes, it is.
Enough sound. You have the idea how this thing sounds. Just a beautiful sound. And like all Marantzes, even this thing is small, you will enjoy this sound. And well, don't wait too long, because within no time these things, they are now about 200, they will cost 300, 400 euro. This is how fast Marantz is going in price. Eh? True or not?
Yeah.
Don't wait too long, you know? And if you see this video, today it is 2021, and the time you see this video, probably that price from 200, 150, 200, what I just gave you, is already a fairy tale, okay? Well, thanks for watching this video, I hope you like it. Put a thumbs up if you did, leave some comments, if you have questions, also leave those questions behind, and for now I say, ciao, ciao.